Hello, my name is Lloyd Knight, and I'd like to welcome everyone to our NAACP Black History Month program here at Thurgood Marshall STEM High School. We're so excited to have each and every one of you here joining us virtually. Carter G. Woodson, a frat brother of mine, in 1915, traveled to DC from Chicago to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the Emancipation Proclamation. During that time, he was inspired and eventually, in 1926, established Negro History Week, which eventually became a monthly celebration of Black excellence. Today, you will see all that Thurgood Marshall and Dayton has to offer in this regard. We're so thankful for you to be here, and we're thankful to the NAACP for partnering here at Thurgood Marshall for our Black History Program.
After you've done all you can. Why did God make me black? Lord, why did you make me black? Why did you make someone the world wants to hold back? Black is the color of dirty clothes, the color of grimy hands and feet. Black is the color of darkness, the color of tired, beaten streets. Why did you give me thick lips, a broad nose, and kinky hair? Why did you make someone who receives that hatred stare? Black is the color of the bruised eye when someone gets hurt. Black is the color of darkness. Black is the color of dirt. How come my bone structure so thick, my hips and my cheeks so high? How come my eyes are brown and not the color of the daylight sky? Why do people think I'm useless? How come I feel so used? Why do some people see my skin and think I should be abused? Lord, I just don't understand. What is it about my skin? Why do some people want to hate me and not know the person within? Black is what people are listed when others want to keep them away. Black is the color of shadows cast. Black is the end of the day. Lord, you know my own people mistreat me, and I know this just ain't right. They don't like my hair. They say I'm too dark, I'm too light. Lord, don't you think it's time for you to make a change? Why don't you redo creation and make everyone the same? And God answered, why did I make you black? Why did I make you black? Get off your knees and look around. Tell me, what do you see? I didn't make you in the image of darkness. I made you in the likeness of me. I made you the color of coal from which beautiful diamonds are formed. I made you the color of oil, the black gold that keeps people warm. I made you from that rich, dark earth that can grow the food you need. Your color's the same as the black stallion. I didn't make you in the image of darkness. I made you in the likeness of me. All the colors of the heavenly rainbow can be found throughout every nation. But when all those colors were blended, you became my greatest creation. Your hair is the texture of lamb's wool. Such a humble little creature he is. I am the shepherd who watches them. I am the one who watches over thee. You are the color of the midnight sky. I put the stars glitter in your eye. There's a smile hidden behind your pain. That's why your cheeks are so high. You are the color of the dark clouds formed when I send my strongest weather. I made your lips so full, so when you kiss the one you love, they will remember. Your stature is strong, your bone structure is thick to withstand the burdens of time. So that reflection that you see in the mirror, I said that reflection that you see when you look in the mirror, that image that looks back at you is me, because I made you in the likeness of me.
In this society, in the United States of America today, we are surrounded by the very wealth and scientific achievements which hold forth a promise of freedom. Freedom is so near, yet at the same time it is so far away. And this thought invokes in me the same sensation I felt as I reflected on my own condition in a jail cell in New York City. For from my cell I could look down upon the crowded streets of Greenwich Village, almost tasting the freedom of movement and the freedom of space, which had been taken from me and all of my sisters in captivity. It was so near, but at the same time, so far away, because somebody was holding the keys that would open the gates to freedom. Our condition here and now, the condition of all of us who are brown and black and working men and women, bears a very striking similarity to the condition of a prisoner. The wealth and the technology around us tell us that a free, humane, harmonious society lives very near. But at the same time, it is so far away because someone is holding the keys and that someone refuses to open the gates to freedom. Like the prisoner, we are locked up with the ugliness of racism and poverty and war and all that attend mental frustration and manipulation. Angela Davis. History.com reports that Angela Davis was born in 1944. She's an educator and activist. She became known for her involvement in a politically charged murder case in the early 1970s. Influenced by her segregated upbringing in Birmingham, Alabama, Davis joined the Black Panthers and an all-Black branch of the Communist Party as a young woman. She became a professor at UCLA, but fell out of favor with the administration due to her ties. Davis was charged with aiding the botched escape attempt of imprisoned Black radical George Jackson and served roughly 18 months in jail before her acquittal in 1972.
There's a ritual that connects us as living people with our ancestors. Sometimes these are called libation. Sometimes this is simply called an African remembrance ritual or a naming ritual. Sometimes we take a plant and pour liquid into that plant and we say the names of those who've come before us. Sometimes we pour liquid on the road or into bowls, and we say the names of grandparents and ancestors that we want to remember in hopes that, number one, our minds become in tune with us being connected with something greater and longer than ourselves, than our short time in the earth. Sometimes this is a spiritual connection. For some people, this is simply a historic connection. This song that I'm going to be playing is coming from an album I'm writing, and it's simply called Ancestral Remembrance Ritual.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Mr. Shields. I'd like to read some remarks prepared by a student named Tariana James, who was unfortunately able to join us today, but nevertheless, her remarks are very powerful and a little bit of a history lesson, which is always a good thing since I'm a social studies teacher. So please enjoy this written, prepared remark from Tariana James. The person that I choose to talk about today will always be important in Black history, and especially for women. Not just African-American women, but all women. The person I have chosen to highlight for Black History Month is Mary Davidson Kinner. Mary Davidson Kinner was an African-American woman who created the sanitary belt. For those of you who don't know what a sanitary belt was, it was an adjustable menstrual pad. Menstrual pads are used by millions of women around the world during the menstrual cycle. While tampons were readily available to women before the sanitary belt, tampons were deemed too indecent for regular use. As a result of these restrictive societal expectations, along with the stigma surrounding menstruation, women were often confined indoors during their periods. Mary Davidson Kinner was an American inventor, and she came up with a solution to this issue. However, due to racial discrimination, her patent for the sanitary belt was prevented for 30 years. Kinner filed for her very first patent on the sanitary belt in 1957. This was an idea she created when she was only 18 years old. This was long before the modern day maxi pad. This was a time when women were still using uncomfortable and unsanitary cloth pads and rags during their period. Kinner's invention was important at the time because it helped stop the stigma surrounding menstruation. Kinner never did get any money from her innovation of the sanitary belt. However, the idea is still important today because all girls have a menstrual cycle and over 57.63 million women use pads worldwide. Kinner is an inspiration because she has the most patents of any African-American woman. Thank you.
And now, I have the privilege of introducing our keynote speaker, Dr. Derek L. Forward. He is the current president of the Dayton chapter of the NAACP, he's a proud graduate of Central State University, and also the International Apostolic University of Grace and Truth. Dr. Forward is a native of Dayton and has been a successful businessman for over 30 years. Dr. Forward has also been a strong advocate for civil rights for more than 17 years, as he has helped lead the NAACP. His motto, if I can help somebody as I pass along, if I can cheer somebody with word or song, if I can show somebody he's traveling wrong, then my living will not be in vain. Move forward with forward. I have very, 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 very happy to introduce Dr. Forward as our keynote speaker for our program today.
Thank you, Principal Knight, for that kind and warm introduction. Makes my heart feel good when I can speak to youth inside of our nation. As I do this quite often, to speak to our youth, because it's vitally important. Education opens doors to unlimited possibilities. And our youth need to ensure that they stay focused on educational opportunities at hand in every aspect of their life. I also want to take this opportunity to thank Nathan Shields, who serves as the advisor of the Move Forward Thurgood Marshall STEM High School chapter, as well as Tawana Branham, who serves as the co-advisor of the Move Forward Thurgood Marshall NAACP High School chapter. I want to say thank you to both of those individuals who are instructors here at your high school. If I have a theme for today, But before I give you my theme, I want to say, first, give an honor and praise to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, because without him, we could do nothing. If I was to have a theme today, it would be the rich history of the name. The rich history of the name. Thurgood Marshall STEM High School, which produced the first NAACP high school chapter in the history of the great Buckeye State of Ohio. The move forward, Thurgood Marshall NAACP high school chapter. The rich history of the name. The Honorable Thurgood Marshall was an American lawyer and civil rights activist who served as Associate Justice of the Supreme Court of the United States from October 1967 until October 1991, a span of over 24 years. He was nominated by the Honorable Lyndon Baines Johnson, the 36th President of the United States of America. Marshall was the court's first African-American justice. Prior to his appointment as a justice, the Honorable John F. Kennedy, the 35th President of the United States of America, appointed Marshall to the United States Court of Appeals for the Second Circuit in 1961. 4 years later, President Lyndon Baines Johnson appointed Marshall as the United States Solicitor General. At the age of 32, still a young man, and as we think about and do every single year in the month of January, and that is to perform a walk through our communities throughout this country to celebrate the life and legacy of Martin Luther King Jr., who died at an early age as well. But at the age of 32, Marshall won U.S. Supreme Court case Chamber versus Florida. That same year, he founded and became the executive director of the NAACP Legal Defense and Education Fund. As the chief counsel of the Legal Defense Fund, he argued many other civil rights cases before the Supreme Court, most of them successfully, including Smith versus Allwright, Shelby versus Kramer, Sweat versus Painter, and McLaurin versus Oklahoma State Regents. His most historic case as a lawyer was Brown v. Board of Education of Topeka, the case in which the Supreme Court ruled that separate but equal public education, as established by Plessis versus Ferguson, was not applicable to public education because it could never truly be equal. In total, Marshall won 29 out of 32 cases he argued before the Supreme Court. So when you think about the name of your school, what's in the name, the rich history of the name, you have a legacy to live up to. When you travel these halls, when you come back to school next month in March, remember the name of Thurgood Marshall. Thurgood Marshall's Bible was used by Vice President Kamala Harris, the first woman elected as Vice President of the United States of America, at her inauguration in Washington on January 20th, 2021, when she was sworn into office. So think about that. Here it is, 2021, our first African-American female elected as the first woman of color to serve in that office, the second highest office in the land. Then we have, think about, rewind the tape back to 2008 when President Obama stood on those same steps and became the first African-American president of these United States of America. The rich history of the name. So when you think about the name of the organization, Move Forward Thurgood Marshall, NAACP STEM High School. Derek Lee Forward is an American social activist and leader in the American Civil Rights Movement. He is the 33rd president of the Dayton unit of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People. He is the youngest person to lead this organization. Forward was first elected as president on November 12, 2006. He is currently in his 8th two-year term, which expires December 31st, 2022. Ford has been involved with many high-profile cases, including the following: a house fire bombing of Sandra Ballard up in Drexel, not too far from here; Kylan English death while in police custody; the closing of Good Samaritan Hospital; a capital investment in the Kroger food store as the Kroger right nearby your school closed down. So we held meetings with the Kroger company to ensure that access was made for the Krogers on Siementhaler. Work collaboratively with community members, educators, and business community to develop a strategic plan to enhance quality education in Dayton. We had all of the superintendents throughout Montgomery County, Ohio, to ascend downtown Dayton to share each one of their respective goals and objectives of how they look for student achievement. And we want to see best practices in how each particular district has performed in various key metric areas. We lobbied members of Congress on many legislative initiatives and worked to ensure our young adults understood their civil and human rights, the rich history of the name. The Move Forward Thurgood Marshall STEM, NAACP STEM High School chapter was first announced during the Thurgood Marshall Army JROTC Military Ball on March 14, 2015, where Derek L. Ford, president of the Dayton Union NAACP, served as the keynote speaker. The Move Forward Thurgood Marshall NAACP High School chapter was the brainchild of Lieutenant Colonel Claudia L. Mason, who was a senior Army instructor here at Thurgood Marshall STEM High School, JROTC Leadership Program. The official kickoff meeting was held on October 20th, 2015, to enlighten and heighten the interests of students in civil and human rights. The organizing committee was formed on October 27, 2015. The organizing meeting was held on October 30th, 2015, and the Move Forward Thurgood Marshall High School chapter was officially chartered by the NAACP National Board of Directors effective February 20th, 2016. The chapter is named in honor of its primary benefactor, President Dr. Derek L. Ford, a visionary, as he made certain everything was in place to establish the chapter. The first official meeting was held at Thurgood Marshall STEM High School on Wednesday, March 3rd, 2016. The chapter's primary objective is to focus on civic engagement, civil rights history, and leadership decision-making amongst teenagers and young adults. The core goals of the organization is pride, service, and leadership. This is an organization that we want you to be a part of. The first elected officers, and this is going to be in history. This is in the history books, right here at your school. Dariana Tolliver served as the first president. Amanda McClellan, first vice president. Gianna Pooler, secretary. Rajay Mack, assistant secretary. Shemaya Wingard, treasurer. And Brianna Thomas, assistant treasurer. And as previously stated, your first advisor was Lieutenant Colonel Claudia L. Mason. There was one appointment to the executive committee, which was Malcolm Hazelton. The Move Forward Thurgood Marshall NAACP High School chapter vision is to develop the next generation of community and civil rights leaders. And you're going to hear about one of those individuals here in just a second. The rich history of the name. So what do you have to aspire to be? When we think about Keith Byers from Roth High School, who played football right on this land before this land was converted, before the school was torn down and converted and made into the current name of Thurgood Marshall. Do you know the history that Colonel White High School, Colonel White Cougars, there's a Roth Cap Falcons over here, the Colonel White school, Cougars across the way. So this school, the school that you walk through the halls and will serve as a freshman, a sophomore, junior, and a senior, you have an opportunity to be a part of this rich legacy. Colonel White, their colors was gold, green, and gold. Their last name was Cougars, or their mascot. Over here, Rolf Falcons was purple. So when I look around this auditorium and I see this purple and gold, it's a blend of two schools. And when I hear the name, Thurgood Marshall Cougars, it's a blend of the name. Know your history of the school from which you are a part of. Keith Byers went on to receive the Dayton Unit NAACP Coveted Community Service Award in 2016 during the 65th Annual Freedom Fund Banquet for his noteworthy and accomplished career playing professional football, otherwise known as the NFL. He exemplified greatness at the professional level, not only as a player, but as a sports broadcaster, serving as a big brother in the Philadelphia community. Pioneering forward to be an ambassador for his community, he richly deposited hope, faith, character in our nation's children by establishing the Byers Bayless Free Football Camp in 1986, right here in Dayton, Ohio. After his retirement from the NFL, he served as a little league baseball coach and high school football coach for many years. The rich history of the name. Think about a young lady who's a freshman right now walking these halls here very soon, named Destiny Ray Walker. She's a freshman here at Thurgood Marshall High School. She served as the president of the Little John Jr. NAACP Youth Council from 2016 to 2018. So that's teaching kids ages 1 through 13 leadership skills and community service at an early age.